what I want you to see today and what I want you to show you. Two hydrogen bonds there are between the thymine and the adenine. Look at their distances. We're going to draw these out, and you're going to see how the end-to-end is in the middle. 290 to 285. Over here, you got 284, 285, 286 end-to-end in the middle. So there's a 5 picometer difference just in the middle of those H bonds length. So now when you're looking at an enzyme that's come along to break these up, not only is this 3 strengths to 2, the distance is shorter, way shorter. The 285 is the same, but here you got another bond at 284, and the end-to-end is 286. Here it's 290. So the C to G bonds, three of the hydrogen bonds in there, it's a different environment in between the two, right? And then so what this does is the lengths are different, 1.11 nanometers, 1.08 nanometers distance from the backbones. The angles are different, 50, 51 degrees, the way these come into the ends, right? This is what we're going to draw now. 50, 51, almost the same angle. But over here, you got a 52 and a 54. It's actually coming in this way. So as it's coming in, it's going to be bigger strain from the sugar backbone and closer, whereas over here coming in, it's going to be wider and further. So wider, further over here, tighter, closer for these. Because these bonds are pulling it. So the effect would be, as you would think, 3 bonds closer, pulling the sugars closer. So the angles are going to be different if the sugar is closer. So we're going to draw these up now. Nucleic acids, DNA, binding. And watch how we do it now. Here's the books diagram. Oh, God, I got a 30-pound sandbag on there. Okay, so if you look at this, you know, it's kind of boring. I mean, I've looked at it before. At least they used the yellow for the double bond in there. But you're using letters. Letters should be used to make words. You don't use letters to represent the chemicals. So that's where the shapes is going to come in to be so beneficial. And we're going to use the aliens for electron pairs that are going to show the bonds. Because what I found interesting, the two ends, one end is a proton acceptor. One end has an H on it, so it's the proton donator. So we have two types of ends on the double ring, the purine, they call it. So your A and G have ends that are in the same circles, but different characters. So we're going to draw those out using the Schroeder diamonds, and watch how this technique makes it so much easier and fun. To review the shapes that we're talking about here, we got the diamonds for carbon. Nitrogen's going to be a right angle, electron pair in the middle. Oxygens are going to get the 2 electron pairs, 2 bonds, like water. So there may be compromises here, but this is what we're going to focus on, the hydrogen bonding via electron pair. Going to have the oxygens from a ketone, and we're going to have the nitrogens out there with NH2s or in the ring. So this is what we're focusing on, mainly these three elements. Remember, the phosphates are in the backbone. So to begin, we're going to draw right in the middle here. Let's do our end to end. How about that? So I see this end. right angle is going to have a double bond over here to a carbon. It's going to go single bond to a carbon. Here, this end, I'm just going to draw it because it's going to be a right angle no matter what. This end has an H. I probably should have drew it that way, but let's do this. We're going to keep the H on there. Watch how my technique is going to make this easier. That's an NH. So now when we do the electron pair of the hydrogen bond, you're going to be able to see it because the proton won't be out there with a line. All right. So this end goes to a carbon. It's going to have a double bound O to it. That O, how it's going to get the hydrogen bond is by the electron pair. So off this carbon here is an NH2 group. So watch here. Here's a right angle. NH2. See, watch. Keep the H on the element instead of drawing the line out there. NH2, we'll just draw a little on there anyway. Now just to keep this true, watch this over here goes to a diamond that goes to a carbonyl, but it doesn't have any effect. Carbon here does a double bond down to another carbon. So what's my rule? And I'm not following it. Double bonds with the yellow right off the bat. Here's a ketone double bond. Here's double bond. Draw it outside the line, too. Let you know there's lots of electron density going on in there, huh? So the rest of the ring really is not become important. We get this nitrogen here that's got an electron pair. Now the way I drew this, we should actually make this closer than that. What do we use for the mind meld? A green? So watch this. We're going to make this hydrogen really big. And we're going to make this electron pair guy really big. So the way this bonds, how can we do it? Green? Yeah, it's got to be green because it comes from the alien. It comes from the little green man. This out here has nothing to do with it. actually got another electron pair. We should probably draw that in over there. Just keep that true, right? Every time I sharpen it with that thing, it's freaking useless now. Over here, we got two electron pairs, but they don't really play into the picture. So off this carbon here, just gets a hydrogen, so apparently the distances isn't enough for that. So we'll just put a no H bond there. Let's see, let's color in the nitrogens so we got nice colorful molecules to work with here. But if you really get to know DNA this intimately, you won't be afraid of it when you